Hey guys, it's Kevin. If you do a DTF DTG on the L1800, you usually see a driver board. What this board does is direct the signals from different sensors, so make a printer be able to read the page width and be able to feed and withdraw films from the rows. Today, I'm going to take a generic board, which is pretty popular in DTF printing, and go over what this board does. So next time disassemble the board, you'll be able to put it back at least. We start with this 4-pin cable. This cable is connected to two buttons. One is go forward, one is go backward. Basically, it's a paper feed and withdraw for your rows. If you need to replace it, you can go to bchtechnology.com, and I have to warn you, you can use this skew to pull this one out. Just do a search, and you're going to see a 4-pin flat flexi cable for Epson, and then you have to select how long is it. Just take a ruler, and normally you will need 40 centimeters. Yeah, let me show you how big 12 centimeter is. So 12 centimeter is this long. Okay. Next to that cable, the bottom cable goes to the main board. And on top of that cable, it goes all the way to the printhead carriage. You can see that bundle, three of them is the printhead. And then there's a sensor cable. And I'm going to go in back between the diagram and the actual video. I talk about this page forward and backward button. And then I remove this cable, and I showed you this cable go all the way to the printed carriage. So in the printed carriage, you get three cables, two cables here, but they split into three, go across the printer. And beside those three or two printed cables, you get another separate cable. That's for the CR cartridge return encoder, which reads the clear cable from the printhead. The sensor is here, so it reads a position of the carriage. And then it's a PW sensor, the page width sensor. And that sensor is in the same cable, which is marking red. And it goes all the way across the printer, and it fits in this slot. And then your breakout board do some processing, rewrite the signal, which on the bottom you should connect this to your main board, which is a CN9 right here. I like this board because it put a relevant socket together, so it's easier to explain to people. So we get those three sockets done, and then we get a couple more to go. I suggest you, one, take a picture, and two, mark the connection before you unplug your FFC cable from the board. Now we get back and work on this socket. Oh, by the way, if you just want to get the diagram which make you work faster, or you don't have time to watch the whole video, you can just go to bchtechnology.com and go search for breakout. Okay, there's a breakout diagram, and you can download this diagram. And this diagram walks you through all the connections and the directions. So for this set of cables, you can see the signal actually goes backwards. It goes back to your control panel, which you turn on the printer and you push buttons. So that's why it goes this way. And it's from connection number 4 on your main board. And then you connect to this cable. And after it overwrites the signal, the cable goes out from here and go to the control panel. Oh, by the way, this control panel looks really strange. And so you go to bchtechnology.com, you go to L1800 and FFC. Here's the cable goes to the control panel. You can see it got like a 3 here, then 2 here, and it's really hard to find this cable. Also, this cable actually is pretty easy to get damaged because you're moving the printer around when you try to fix it, and the operation just wear out the cable. And sometimes the printer doesn't turn on is because of this cable. Now the last set of cable from this row. And this last one, the cable is from the main board, CN5, and then connect to CN1 on the subboard. And this subboard is normally screwed on the duplexer of your printer. I have it unscrewed, but I just noticed there's a blue wire, and here's the APG unit that I'm going to talk about it. And this subboard communicate a couple things. One is the PE sensor, which connect to connection number 2. See the connection number 2, the yellow socket? And the PE means a paper eject sensor. See that green wire? It go all the way to the other side of the printer. When the printer has a few more paper, it will push a little lever on that sensor. And connection number 6 is PF sensor, paper feed sensor. Paper feed measured how fast the paper is feeding, and is measured by this clear disc. And here's the PF sensor. And this actually has a little sensor on itself, which is ESF. If you install this on the duplexer, there will be a ESF bar that block this sensor. And then on this subboard, it also come out 2 wires, the blue one and the red one, which connect to your APG unit. I'm going to have another video for the APG unit. Basically, for the APG unit, you get the motor. The motor connects to CN11-8 right here on your main board. And then the blue wire is connected to the top of the sensor. There are 2 sensors look exactly the same, except one connect to the blue wire. Just remember, sky is blue, so that blue one is always on top. And then you get another one connect to the bottom. If you L1800 has H air, this thing messed up. The APG unit got messed up. Or because of this feedback, you might have this board here gets messed up. So just remember, this one take the signal from the main board, connection number 5. And then connect to number 1 on the subboard. Okay, we cover all those sockets, and then this wire is connect to the paper feed motor. Where to find the paper feed motor? It's the motor that's near the paper feed sensor, PF sensor. And then here's a socket for ASF motor. ASF motor, it drives to the page feed for the printer. And normally, if you have it's disconnected. So let me show you. So this is the ASF motor, which has got disconnected. So what you do is take this cable, and not this cable, the other cable connect to it, and rewire that cable back to your breakout board. Okay, the last thing is this 24-volt input. So you plug here, and here, so you get a buck converter converted to different voltage, and then it drives this breakout board. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.